My name is Charlie Boy Howard and I fight out of Dell's Fitness Center in Gravesend.
My name is Mathieu Morciano. My team is Evolution Pancras and Wadoshow Karate Club.
I've trained very, very hard for this fight. I had a fight 2 weeks ago, so I've just carried on my training in the gym, carried on with a goodie and instead sharp in the gym.
I train very hard on the stand-up and the wrestling. I would like to say good luck. A fight to be stand-up and wrestling.
My prediction on the fight is I'm going to win. I don't go in there with, oh, I might win, I might do this, I might do that. My prediction is I'm going to win. I don't care how I win, but a win. The W will be coming home with me.
For the fans of Killacam, I love you.
My message is to look out for me. I'm the next up-and-coming thing. And of course, I'm bringing my team, CBH Army. We're going to overtake the Winter Gardens.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is an amateur mixed martial arts contest. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner in Paris, France, with a record of 6 wins and 2 losses, Mathieu Morciano. And now, for his opponent, fighting out of the red corner and DFC, Charlie Boy Howard!
Thank you. So this bout is brought to you by Morgan's Wine Bar Margate, the venue of our official after party. And if we look at the tail of the tape, Mathieu Morciano, 6-2 from Paris, France. Charlie Boy Howard, 10 wins from the DFC. And Chris, on paper, this has really got them going. This is a really exciting international. And a big step up for Charlie Boy.
Big time. Charlie going up to 70 kilograms. Usually fights a little bit lower at featherweight. But he said, look, coming in here, 8 days notice, I want to be tested. I want to go for it. And I know that the Frenchman has got some mega skills, got some outstanding guys there in his corner. But then again, so does Charlie.
That's right, Chris. And you could hear the crowd's response to this. And they know this is one of the big events early in this stacked show tonight, to be honest.
Fantastic pass there from Charlie Howard. Real good job stuffing the knee, getting there to north-south, realizing he was in danger, getting scrambled away from, so he went back to the other side for side control. Got great grappling instruction there, and DFC, guy from Silverbacks in his corner. Shout out to Valmir Neto, one of the very best in the UK in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. So, wow, Charlie doing a great job back here in north-south. Possibly looking to set up a submission here. I haven't really tailored out what he's looking for yet, though, Malcolm.
No, he looked to his own corner to see for instruction himself. But I've had the privilege of watching Charlie Boy on a number of occasions, Chris. And he's a very, very cool young man for the age. Stays very calm. He's very technical. And in one of his bouts, as I said to you when we were talking about this fight earlier, he was losing the first two rounds, pulled out a fantastic submission in the third. But listen to the crowd now. He might not need a submission at this point in time, Chris.
Big ground and pound from Charlie Boy Howard. And I like the way he was shutting down the hip movement of his opponent, Morciano. And really, at this point, Mateo having no answer here, unable to escape and just eating shots.
He's getting pounded. You're right, Chris. This could be all over soon. He's got to intelligently defend himself. And Charlie Boy is really reining in the blows.
And Andrew Nichols having a very close look at this, Malcolm. If he cannot improve his position, Charlie Howard is going to walk away with a big finish here.
And again, I talked about his thinking strategy. He looked to his corner there as he was doing the ground and pound.
Outstanding explosion, though, from Morciano and getting back out. But Charlie with relentless control. I like the way he passes off that leg control. Boom, right back here, nearly into half guard. Good head pressure. More importantly, controlling the hips of Morciano.
Well, you mentioned the pedigree of Morciano. We haven't really, at this moment, had an opportunity to see his class because Charlie Boy has been all over him at the moment, constant pressure, right in his own corner as well. Perfect here for the young man from DFC at the moment.
And they're calling for the Charlie Howard to posture up and rain down those shots continuously. And I think, at this point, Mateo's a little bit bewildered at what's occurred so far. Charlie is really going after him and working a high rate of attack, Malcolm.
And he replied with a second and third knee to Mateo's knee. And Morciano in all sorts of trouble here. But what a tough competitor, Chris, because he's taken so much of this.
This must be nearly 40, 50 unanswered shots so far from Charlie Boy Howard. As Howard mauls him here
the
against the fence.
The gun shield's out as well now, Chris. How much longer?
Unbelievable stuff here from Howard with that weight distribution. He is staying so tight on his opponent, so heavy. A level of intensity we've never seen. I think the fire's been really lit underneath Howard for this bout here in Killacam tonight, Malcolm.
Well, Chris, we've mentioned many times, you said young men when they want to be tested. The moment you mention an international bout, it becomes a lot more than just their personal pride. They feel they've got the weight of a nation on their back as well. International bouts often bring out the very best in a competitor.
And when you got the Charlie Boy Howard army there in your corner shouting, going bananas, it's pretty tough not to be inspired. And they are literally blowing the roof off here in the Winter Gardens as Charlie, nearing the end of the round, has slowed down the pace but kept that control hot.
And again, the crowd responds to this onslaught. But if we look at Morciano, incredible resilience to still be there.
And Charlie on target almost every single time. You know, he's got a very high work rate here with those punches, but also his accuracy. And, you know, Mateo nodded there, but that round was all Charlie Boy Howard, Malcolm.
Indeed, Chris, it was. And we just wonder, can he sustain this intensity, possibly across two more rounds?
It was just a picture-perfect ground-and-pound assault throughout, Malcolm. Cannot wait for round two.
Oh. So Chris, an incredible start from Charlie Boy Howard. What has Marciano got to do to get back into this? He was virtually mugged in that opening round.
Well, I was watching the two of them before actually this round began. They were pacing back and forth. Step one would have been to recover, and Marciano looks pretty fresh. Then again, I'd expect cardio to not be a serious problem here in the second round at this weight class. Having said that, Marciano needs to avoid the takedown. He needs to impose his strikes and get in and get out, not allow Charlie to change levels and get underneath those hips like he did successfully a couple times in round one.
Yes, Chris, they both exchanged punches and kicks. As you said, Marciano's still fresh and smiling at Charlie Boy. And Charlie Boy calling him on there, saying, come on, he's a very, very confident young man.
And Howard, a man on a mission at this point. But make no mistake, you know, you can't get in the ring and think you're bulletproof. When you got a guy like Marciano on the other end of things, he can change stuff in an instant. And, you know, he tagged him there with that right cross a moment ago.
There oh, but looking. Charlie slipped under that one, Chris.
That was good head movement from Charlie. And there we go. That's that trip he was looking for. Now he's on the, got that reverse body lock. Jumps on his back like an orangutan. Way! This looks pretty close here, Malcolm.
Yes, superb transition there from Charlie Boy. And that's what I said. He's really developing at all aspects. And again, after a good start from Marciano, he's really in the ascendancy once more.
And the way he was throwing down those shots unanswered, like I said, I thought the way he stretched Marciano out, that could be the beginning of the end so far, Malcolm. Man.
Oh, he has. He's seen enough. The referee has seen enough. Marciano, he was resilient, but he can't keep taking that level of punishment unanswered.
Charlie Boy Howard, we knew he was great, but he was maybe even better than we thought, Malcolm, as he gets greeted by his family there. What an outstanding performance. What a relentless performance from Charlie Boy Howard.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for your two fighters. However, after two rounds of action, here in the lightweight division, referee in charge, Andrew Nichols, has called a stop to this contest, declaring your winner via TKO, Charlie Boy Howard. Let's hear it from Mateo Marciano. Charlie Boy Howard. Charlie, somebody tells me it's the CBH Army here in the house tonight.
The CBH Army never ever let me down. I come to battle, the CBH Army come to battle every time.
Now Charlie, from the walkout all the way to the very last moment of that fight, you were a man on a mission. You came in here and stepped up in weight class tonight. You wanted a tough opponent, and you must have really been motivated to go after him because that was a performance, young man.
I'm motivated every time I fight. I fight for my family, my friends. I'm motivated every time I fight. Like you said, I stepped up and went. Thank you to the guy for taking the fight on short notice. Because Tom Richards, where the fuck are you? Get in this cage and face me. Where are you?
Charlie, it seemed the difference was your ground and pound and your positional control. You passed his guard every single time. You've got some all-star guys there in your corner tonight.
Listen, them guys in my corner, my guys from DFC couldn't make it. But every time, did you see that groundwork? Team VN Jiu-Jitsu, Valmeneta Jiu-Jitsu, the best black belt in the UK. Nobody can test that guy's Jiu-Jitsu. The best Jiu-Jitsu in the UK.
Charlie, final question tonight. We've got a big title bout between Alec Connolly and Ben Manua. What are your thoughts on that fight? I've been hearing from the promotional head honchos, they want you back December 12th to fight for the title, young man.
Like I said before, bring King Kong in here and I'll fight King Kong. I've got a lot of respect for Alec Connolly. I don't see that fight going ahead, I'm going to be honest with everybody, because me and Alec train. Jack McGee comes over to our gym, we go over there. I don't see me and Alec fighting. And I also have a lot of respect for the Lions Pride boys, a lot of respect because they are good. But they are not teammates. And if it comes, if Ben wins tonight, then I will step up in here. Business is business. But I'm not calling anybody out on that fight because I like that fight. That's a very, very, very good fight. I like that fight. But if business means business, I will step up in here on where, ready and prepare to fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it here first. Charlie Boy Howard.